للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد فإن شاء الله this will not be the whole of Surat al-Hujurat but it will be portions from it from some of the speech or the explanation of Sheikh Muhammad bin Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah. After Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, he praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all of creation, and he sends peace and blessings upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he begins the surah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. All you who believe, do not put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. O you who believe, do not put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger and fear Allah. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all hearing, sami', or the perfect hearing, and the most knowledgeable, alim. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says, اعلم أن الله تعالى إذا ابتدأ الخطاب بقوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا فإنه كما قال عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه إما خير تؤمر به إلا خير تؤمر به وإما شر تنهى عنه. So whenever you hear يا أيها الذين آمنوا, then either you're going to be commanded with a good or forbidden from an evil. That was the statement of Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. In fact, another wording says we used to pay attention. يعني would be more attentive whenever we'd hear the verse يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, because either we're going to be commanded with good or forbidden from an evil act. This is the way the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, they will be listening. They want to see what's going to come afterwards, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the believers, and they would like to follow that which Allah has commanded them to do. The Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, the best people ever to be, subhanAllah. The best people ever to be, they kept away from haram, they kept away. Look, when the verses were revealed regarding alcohol in Medina, the streets were flowing with khamar, because they threw those vessels or those bottles that had alcohol, they threw all of that and they spilled it onto the ground and it flowed, subhanAllah. When the verses were revealed regarding the niqab, يعني the jilbab, or the women to cover themselves and be chaste in that dressing, subhanAllah, we had women going out and they would go out with coverings, whatever cover they could get hold of. Even in narration in Bukhari, we have the women would go out, na'am, and they would look like black crows, meaning they would cover themselves. That was as they went out for Fajr, waqt al-ghalas, when it was still in the beginning of Fajr, they would go out to pray, and that was their state. So, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, all you who believe. And there's another verse which mentions, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا آمِنُوا, all you who believe, believe. And this means, جَدِّدُوا إِيمَانَكُمْ, يعني purify or يعني renew your iman. Because iman, your iman and your deen, it becomes, you may fall short, you may be deficient, you are human. And we all make mistakes. Ibn Adam khatta' wa khayru khatta'in at-tawwabun. All of the children of Adam make mistakes, and the best of those who make mistakes are those who are repentful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it may be you fall short after a period of time, like a cloth becomes old. So you need to renew your iman. Jaddidu imanakum. Renew it with what? With recitation of the Quran, with being with the righteous, with keeping up your five daily prayers in the masjid, with striving to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all those things that Allah loves, and keeping away from all those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes. And so you live a life of taqwa. Because taqwa, as Taqib ibn Habib mentioned, it is a light from Allah. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you do actions of goodness, obedience, upon a light from Allah, means guidance, seeking His reward. Keeping away from the prohibited matters, upon a light from Allah, fearing His punishment. This is taqwa, such that you make a barrier between you and the haram. And Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah said, فَإِنَّهُ كَمَا قَالَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ بْنُ مُسْعُودِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ إِمَّا خَيْرٌ تُؤْمَرُ. No doubt, a good that you're going to be commanded with. وَإِمَّا شَرٌ تُنْهَا عَنْهُ. So therefore, listen attentively and listen to the good that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to call you to. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Do not put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger. لَا تُقَدِّمُوا أي لَا تَتَقَدَّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Don't put yourself forward. وَالْمُرَادُ لَا تَسْبِقُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ بِقَوْلٍ أَوْ بِفِعْلٍ. Do not precede Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a speech, with any speech or any action. Do not precede Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with any speech or any action. And Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah continued and he said, وَقِيلَ الْمَعْنَى لَا تُقَدِّمُ شَيْئًا بَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَكِلَهُمَا صَبَّانِ فِي مَصَبٍ وَاحِدٍ. Do not put yourself forward in front of Allah, يعني in anything, in any matter, in front of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from speech or from action. And here, Shaykh Uthaymeen, I'm not going to read all of it, but in summary, do not go put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger. He mentions from that which is the severest thing that you put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger is the innovations. And worse than that is shirk, because Allah will not forgive shirk. Allah will not forgive that you commit shirk with Him, that you associate partners with Him, and He forgives anything else besides that to whomsoever He wills. So do not fall into shirk. Be careful. Be careful that you fall into shirk. And the Messenger will seek refuge from falling into shirk knowingly and seek His forgiveness from falling into shirk unknowingly. Yani this is the Rasulullah. So how about us? And he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him to be the best of the prophets. And Sayyidu waladi Adam wala fakhr. He used to say, I'm the best of the children of Adam and I'm not boasting. The best of the children and Allah chose him. But he didn't want anyone to exaggerate in praising him. لا تطروني كما أطرعت النصارى عيسى بن مريم ولكن قولوا عبد الله ورسوله. Don't over-exaggerate in praising me. Just like the Christians over-exaggerated in praising Isa ibn Maryam. But say, I'm a slave of Allah and His Messenger. This Ubudiyya, which is Shaykh Zantaymi rahimahullah wrote a beautiful book on it. Ubudiyya, servitude, that your life, your death, and before that your prayer, your sacrifice for Allah. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. This is the ubudiyya of your prayer, your sacrifice, your life and your death for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِلَّهِ لَمُ الْإِسْتِحْقَاقِ. For Allah alone. No one else deserves that. No one else deserves that except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Signifying al-ikhlas, sincerity. Being sincere before you do an action, before you say a statement. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call you to account. There isn't a statement that you say except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those angels are writing it down. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. There isn't a statement that you utter except there's raqib, atid, waiting to write it down. كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Those angels, honorable angels, writing down all that you have done in this life. Shaykh Rabi' Hafidhullah mentions that look at the scales and how deep, how precise the scales are. But even an atoms, that's a loose translation. Better than that, in time of Sahaba, the smallest thing, like an ant, even an atom's weight of a deed, even an atom's weight of a good deed will be weighed. And even an atom's weight, I'll go back to that atom's weight, because that's in the translations in the Sahaba. Even an ant's weight of a bad deed will be weighed. And you will be weighed. A man will come, is large, semeen, but he will not weigh even the wing of a mosquito. SubhanAllah. So the person will be weighed. His actions will, yani his deeds will be weighed and his scrolls will be weighed. The man who come, who will come with 99 scrolls of bad deeds. One of the scrolls is as far as the eye can see. And he thinks that's halas. He will think that he is perished and he is lost. And then it will come out, it will be brought out for him, al-pitaqa. The pitaqa, which is the card written on it, yani is his tawheed, his ikhlas, his adherence to this deen with sincerity. And that will outweigh all of those 99 scrolls of bad deeds. Ya Abdullah, This is proof that the heaviest thing on the scales, Yawm al-Qiyamah, is your aqeedah. As Shaykh Rabi Habudullah said in his explanation of Usul al-Sunnah, the heaviest thing is your aqeedah. Therefore, busy yourself in learning aqeedah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, la tuqaddimu bayna yaday Allahi wa rasulih. First and foremost, in aqeedah and in methodology. Don't put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in belief and in methodology, in actions, in ibadat, I mean. Your ibadat should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خُدُوا عَنِي مَنَاسِكَكُمْ. When you go for the hajj, take from me the hajj rites. When you pray, صَلُّوا كَمَا رَأَيْتُمُونِي أُصَلِّي. Pray as if you see me pray. You are upon ibadah, according to the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Allah said to you and to me, خُدُوا مَا أَتَيْنَاكُمْ. In the other verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the Messenger gives you, then take it. Whatever he forbids you from, then keep away from it. So take that which Allah's Messenger brought you. Don't be of those who turn away. وَأَنْتُمْ تَسْمَعُونَ. While you're here, Allah says, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهُ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولُ وَلَا تَوَلُّوا عَنْهُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَسْمَعُونَ. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, and do not turn away from him while you're here, while you hear the message. Don't turn away from him. Rasulullah came and his Khatim al-Nabiyyin, the best of all the prophets, the seal of all the prophets, and he came and he strove, and the Sahaba carried his deen for us. We don't turn away. We strive and we hold on. Just as Allah commanded Rasulullah to strive and hold on. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ. And be firm in holding on to that which Allah has commanded you with. استقم and استقامة. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Those who say Allah is our Lord, then they are upright. Rabbun Allah, they are upon Tawheed. They are upon the correct Iman. That comes first. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Then they are upright upon that. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَنْ لَا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. Angels will descend upon them at the point of death. Do not be distressed nor feel any sadness. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. We are your guardians and protectors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent in this dunya and the akhirah. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِ أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ. You will have everything that you desire of good in paradise and that which you were promised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared. أَعْدَدْتُ لِأُمَّةِ مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ. I've prepared for my ummah what no eye has seen, no ear has heard, وَلَا خَطْرَ فِي قلب رجل منكم. Nor any heart could even imagine or realize how great what Allah has prepared for the believers. Jannah, عرضها السماوات والأرض. Paradise, its extent and its vastness over the heavens and the earth. Paradise, Jannah, a life of bliss in this life and a life of bliss in the hereafter. Yes, the people of Tawheed are the happiest people in this dunya. They're the ones that don't put themselves forward in front of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're the ones who take this verse and they implement it. لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله. واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. And fear Allah, because if you don't, and if you turn away from Allah and you go and put yourself forward in aqeedah other than the aqeedah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you go and bring a bid'ah in the actions and in belief, then know Allah is سميع عليم. Allah knows what you're doing and He hears what you're doing. And He hears what you're doing. And He will bring you to account. Today is Amal. This is Darul Mamar. This is the land or the earth of passing by. And tomorrow or the next day is Darul Qarar. The abode where you and me will return. And we will return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what have we prepared for that meeting? What have we prepared regarding this verse? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la tuqaddimu bayna yaday Allahi wa rasulihi. Just this verse. We could recite it all night, repeat it like the Salaf used to recite. One verse, they used to recite all night, just pondering over that verse. La tuqaddimu bayna yaday Allahi wa rasulihi. La tuqaddimu bayna yaday Allahi wa rasulihi. Don't put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger. I said, Wattaqullah, inna Allaha samiun alim. Don't put yourself forward in terms of these innovations that you have made up, in terms of splitting into groups and parties, in terms of reviling the ulama. Don't put yourself forward. Allah has praised them and raised them many levels. يَرْفَعِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ دَرَجَاتٍ. Raise them many levels. And you go and speak ill of them. And you go and insult them. They're the ones who call into Tawheed and Sunnah 60, 70 years of their life. And they continue to call to that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called you to, reviving the Sunnah, because the ulama are warathatul al-anbiya. In al-anbiya, lam yuwarithu dinaran wala dirhaman, walakin warathul ilm. Faman akhadha akhadha bihadhil wafir. Whoever gains knowledge, is like he's gained a great treasure. So be with the ahl ilm. Be with the people of knowledge, the people of hadith. عليك بالحديث وأهله فرأي ليل والحديث نهار. For opinion is like night, unclear. While hadith is clear, is like day, it's clear. ولربما غلط الفتى سبل الهدى والشمس بازغة لها أنوار. And it may be a person doesn't know the path of guidance while the sun is shining in splendor. It's clear. Maybe a youth, he can't see the path. Without knowledge, you will go all over the place. So be with أهل العلم. You will see much khair. You will see much understanding in terms of your, not just the aqidah and the manhaj, the methodology and how to worship Allah, in terms of your tarbiyah, in terms of your manners and your actions and how to be and live, and how to understand khilafat, those differences in fiqh. We should not split any one of us. The differences in fiqh that somebody bases upon a way of, bases opinion upon one of the scholars, which is based upon a hadith of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, or an ijma' from the companions. Rahmukullah. And they differ upon a particular matter, then we should not differ. We should not make iftiraq, split up into groups and parties because of matters of fiqh, where there is a difference that is permitted. But in terms of aqidah, the aqidah is one. The belief is one. Allah says, وَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا. And if they believe as you, Sahaba, believe, then you will be guided. Then they will be guided. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيْنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِي غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Whoever contends with the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after the guidance has been given to them, and they follow away other than the way of the believers, we land them in the path they have chosen. And land him in the hellfire, or leave him in the path they have chosen, land him in the hellfire, one evil abode that is. Surat al-Nisa 115. Going back to the understanding of Sahaba radiallahu anhum, in all of it, to understand our deen, they were khayrun nas. As in the hadith in Bukhari, khayrun nas yuqarni. Thumma ladina ilunahum, thumma ladina ilunahum. The best people are in my generation. Then them to come after them, then them to come after them. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, the best people. Radiallahu anhum wa radu anhu. Allah is pleased with them and them pleased with him. إِذَا ذُكِرَ أَصْحَابِ فَمْسِكُوا. When my companions are mentioned and withhold, don't speak bad about them. لَوْ أَنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ تَصَدَّقَ بِأُحُدٍ ذَهَبًا مَا بَلَغَ مُدَّ أَحَدٍ وَلَا نَصِيفًا. If one of you were to give charity the size of Uhud in gold, he will not be able to reach a mud, a handful of charity that they put forward. That's considered you put forward Uhud in charity. You will not reach even a handful. You not reach two hands put together, mud, or even half of that, wala nasifa. So the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they strove and they carried this deen. يَحْمِلُ هَذَا الْعِلْمِ مِنْ كُلِّ خَلَفٍ عُدُولُ. They were the udul. They were the just ones and the upright ones, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. And they carried this deen for us, for it to reach us. And their students carried it, and their students carried it. Ulama after ulama throughout the ages. Every century Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed this deen with ulama at the head of the century. As in the hadith in Sunan Abi Dawood, in Allah yab'athu ala ra'si al-qarn man yujaddidu lil umma umura deenha. Allah will raise at the head of every century those scholars who will revive the deen as a whole. Look at the wording of this hadith. In Allah yab'athu ala ra'si al-qarn, at the head of the century. This is not the Gregorian century, this is the Hijri. The Hijri century. At 1400, at the head of this century, 1400, Shaykh Abdul Aziz bin Baz rahimullah was in his 60s. Shaykh Al-Albani rahimullah was in his 60s. And Shaykh Nu'taymin rahimullah was in his 60s. At the head of the century, I found a book by Shaykh Al-Albani rahimullah, 1399 printed. The reviving the Usul al-Sunnah Imam Ahmad, Allahu Akbar. And before that, Sharh al-Sunnah that he put out. And the scholars, subhanAllah, they left behind much knowledge. Whoever gains a great treasure. No doubt, these great scholars who lived in this time, and they left behind students. And those that lived in their time, the likes of Sheikh Muqbil, rahimahullah, who we saw in Jeddah, we went to visit him in the hospital. And subhanAllah, so much concern he had, so much concern to follow the Sunnah and to establish the Sunnah. He said, where are you from? He said, Morocco. He said, tell Maghrawi that he has to repent. Subhanallah, straight away, tell Maghrawi he has to repent. Nowadays, people just doesn't matter, let's go, doesn't, you know. No, we don't accept sins, don't accept errors, don't accept mistakes, whoever it comes from. Errors are errors, they don't accept what should go forward is the haqq. Al-haqqu min rabbikum, fala takunanna min al-mumtareen. Truth is from your Lord, so don't be from the argumentative ones. Qul jaa al-haqq, wa zahaqa al-batil, inna al-batila kana zahuqa. Truth has come and falsehood has perished. Falsehood will always perish. They will never be able to go above the haqq. Al-haqqu ya'lu, wa la yu'la alayh. Truth will always be above. Wa tilka hujjatuna atainaha Ibrahim ala qawmih. نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ حَكِيمٌ عَلِيمٌ. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, such is the hujjah that we have given Ibrahim when he argued with his people and he established the proof on them. تِلْكَ حُجَّتُنَا آتَيْنَاهَا إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ. We raise many levels whomsoever we will. Here Shaykh al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he mentioned, and those like him, يعني upon his path, from the ulama, from the scholars. So Allah's raised them with what? With hujjah. With qala Allah, qala Rasulullah, qala sahaba. This, the dalil, the proof. Al-ilmu qala Allah, qala Rasuluhu, qala sahabatu laysa bitamwih. Without doubt, this is ilm. Al-ilmu qala Allah, qala Rasuluhu, qala sahabatu laysa bitamwih. Mal-ilmu nasbaka li khilafi safahatin bayna Rasuluhu, bayna ra'i fulani. It is foolishness to compare the statement of anyone, or faqih, or whoever is a layman or even a scholar, with the statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the deen is complete and it cannot be added to. And Shaykh Mu'taymin rahimahullah mentions those verses and those ahadith, the hadith of Irbad radiallahu anhu, alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnati al-khulafa al-rashidin al-mahdiyina min ba'di wa iyaakum ihdathati al-umur. So he says, first and foremost, don't put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Rasul in innovations. ومن التقدم بين يدي الله ورسوله البدع. Innovations. Innovations are evil. As Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah said, innovations are more, bid'ah is more pleasing to Iblis than sins. Because a person may repent from his sins, but not necessarily from his bid'ah. So bid'ah, the Prophet said, warned against it before its appearance. من عمل عمل ليس عليه أمر فهو رد. من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. يعني the Prophet ﷺ refuted the bid'ah and the one who brought the bid'ah. He refuted them. And he said about the different groups that the ummah will split into 73 sects. افترقت اليهود على 71 فرقة وافترقت النصارى على 72 فرقة وستفترق أمتي. My ummah will split into 72 sects. على 72 فرقة. على 72 فرقة. كلها في النار. All of it is destined for the hellfire. All of these groups. إلا, except one. إلا واحدة. They said, which one, O Messenger of Allah? He said, من كان على مثل ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. This hadith is حسن للشواهد. And there is a, mashallah, تبارك الله, for those who want to study this hadith, you can get, mashallah, Jamie Islami has done a nice, one of the students has done a nice bath where he gathered all of the a'immat al-hadith, the scholars of hadith, and their acceptance of this hadith. And with the numerous wordings of this hadith, that it has reached the level of Hasan al-Shawahid due to so many reports. But the Ahl al-Bid'ah, they don't like this hadith. They don't want this hadith to be heard and to be mentioned. But we mention it because we love the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sunnah, should go forward, and it will go forward with or without us. And in the other wording, which is sahih, la ghubara alayh, and that is when they said, which one, O Messenger of Allah? He said, Al-Jama'ah. Al-Jama'ah. Which is the Jama'ah at the time of Sahaba? Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna, Allah al-Hamah, used to say, the Jama'ah at the time of Rasulullah is the Sahaba. So Al-Jama'ah, the way of Sahaba. Not to Jama'ah al-Tabliq, or Jama'ah al-Ikhwan Muslimin, or Jama'ah al-Takfir. Jama'ah, the way of Sahaba, radiallahu anhum. They had the best teacher, and they were the best students. La tuqaddimu bayna yaday Allahi wa Rasulihi, wa taqullaha. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Then he went over the names of Allah, سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. That we affirm that which Allah subhanahu has affirmed for Himself with all the beautiful names that He has mentioned and all the lofty attributes. And likewise, he moved on after mentioning that. He moved on to mention the next part. And so we are skipping a lot of what he has mentioned here because of the time. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَرْفَعُوا أَصْوَاتَكُمْ فَوْقَ صَوْتِ النَّبِيِّ. Do not raise your voices above the voice of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَلَا تَجْهَرُوا لَهُ بِالْقَوْلِ كَجَهْرِ بَعْضِكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ. And do not raise your voice or speak loudly as you would speak to others. يعني in the same manner. أَنْ تَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. Such that or lest your actions become null and void while you don't even realize it. So don't put yourself forward in front of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And next one, don't raise your voice above that. And then he mentioned the qissa of the Sahabi Thabit ibn Qais ibn Shammas radiallahu anhu, who was known to have a loud voice, and he feared for himself that this verse was referring to him, and so he locked himself or he stayed in his home, and the Messenger asked about him, and when he asked about him, he mentioned that it's not referring to him. وَإِنَّهُ قَدْ حَبِطَ. So he thought that his actions were null and void, just as the verse mentions. وَإِنَّهُ مِنْ أَهِلِ النَّارِ. And he feared that he is from the people of hellfire. فَدَعَهُ الرَّسُولُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So the Messenger called for him. فَحَضَرَ. And he came and he was present. فَأَخْبَرَهُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنَّهُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. So the Prophet said, no, you are from the people of Jannah. From the Sahaba that he mentioned, specifically by name, as being from the people of Jannah. And that is, subhanAllah, Thabit ibn Qais ibn Shammas. SubhanAllah, this Sahabi, look at his, the verse was revealed, and he thinks it's about himself. This is how Sahaba radhiallahu anhu were. They implemented these verses, just as the narration mentions, that they would learn the Qur'an 10 verses at a time, learn not just its recitation, but learn its understanding and its action. They would practice what it entails. That is the way of the Sahaba radhiallahu anhum. That they would consider, and look at the fear of Allah that they had, the iman that they had. He considered himself to be the one referred to in this verse. As for saying that Fulan is from a person of paradise, we cannot say that. The Aqidah of Ahl-Sunnah, we cannot say Fulan, anyone, is from the people of paradise, except those that Allah and His Messenger have mentioned. Except those that have that shahada from Rasulullah that he is from the people of Jannah. Like Ukasha radiu anhu, who asked, let me be, or ask Allah that, or it may be, let it be that I'm one of them, asking the Messenger, hoping that he's one of them, meaning the 70,000 who will enter paradise without any reckoning and without any punishment. No. And he said, you are one of them. You are one of them. 70,000 of those. لا يتطيرون ولا يكتوون وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. They rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't rely on charms, these good luck and bad luck charms. They don't, thank Allah, ولا يستقون, I missed that one, ولا يستقون. They don't seek a cure from others, meaning for them to read over them. Rather, they read over themselves. Be careful of these so-called businessmen who go around reading over water and then they sell it for you. Sheikh Abdul Bukhari said, why don't they read over the whole tank? For them, read over the whole tank. They read over it, they sell it, make a business out of it. Like the one in East London, Allah Hadi. And even to the extent that they put a hand over a woman and said, I'm doing ruqya over her. Allah Hadi, you need ruqya. You need ruqya. Because you're doing that, which is prohibited. And then he said, oh, Sheikh Rabi said it's allowed. A'udhu billah, Ali Allah as well. At the same time, Sheikh Rabi said it's allowed. A'udhu billah. It's kadib, lying about the mashayikh like this. Mashayikh, not like that. In fact, Shaykh Rabi wrote a book called the Ruqya, about Ruqya. In fact, it was a lecture, an advice, and it came out into a pamphlet format and refuted those people who do that. He said, who put you in that situation? That you think that you are the one that people should turn back to. And you have these individuals called websites. They make it so dazzling and so that people can call them, that he's the Raqi, he's the man, he's the one that... Teach the people the Sunnah. Read Fatiha over yourself, as in the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu. When he done it over the Sayyid al-Qawm, and he was cured after he was bitten by a scorpion. He was cured. After Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu read over him, and he was Sayyid al-Qawm. the leader of our people there. And then they gave him some pieces of meat. Or he took that, he didn't eat it until he didn't consume it until he asked the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the Prophet said, make me a share with you. Meaning that it's allowed. Afterward, after the man is cured, you setting up a website, you having a shop, the man is still sick and you're still getting money from him. You see the contradiction? You see the lies? You see the opposition to the sunnah that these people are upon? They're taking money from people and the man is still sick. And subhanAllah, this tawassu' of, again, reading over the women, a man reading over a woman, and subhanAllah, Allah yahdik. Don't do that, ya akhi. Don't do that. This is not from the sunnah. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding these affairs. Fear Allah regarding these affairs. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned, it's easier, ahwanu alay. It's easier for me that I be pierced with an iron rod than touch a woman. Yani, like you find someone, they come and they want to shake your hands. It's easier for me for an iron to be put and pierced, a hot iron to be pierced in my head or in myself than to touch a woman that's not from my maharim, yani the women that's not from my, it's not my mother, nor is it my sister, nor is it my wife, nor is it my daughter. SubhanAllah. That is the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And these individuals, they make business. For them, business takes over, takes precedence. No. لا تقدموا بين يدي الله ورسوله واتقوا الله إن الله سميع عليم. So Thabit ibn Qais, radiallahu anhu, he feared for himself that verse was referring to him, and that is from taqwa, from iman. And then the next verse, in the الذين يغضون أصواتهم عند رسول الله أولئك الذين امتحن الله قلوبهم للتقوى. Now Allah praises those who lower their voice in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that they have been tested, not only that, blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but their hearts have piety. لهم مغفرة وأجر عظيم. They will have forgiveness and a great reward. They are the ones Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised many levels and accepted and forgiven. And then Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentions, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ صَبَرُوا حَتَّى تَخْرُجَ إِلَيْهِمْ لَكَرَهُ. This is referring to the إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا. This is referring to the next verse where those who used to call upon the messenger side, they would go to his house and they would call upon him, and it's not allowed for them to call upon him more than, if they knock three times, the sunnah is to go. But to remain and call, then that was considered to be not allowed. So, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُنَادُونَكَ مِنْ وَرَاءِ الْحُجُرَاتِ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. And here, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says, here, يَعْقِلُونَ means لا يعلمون. They don't understand, they don't know the correct understanding regarding this, those who did that. يعني ليس عندهم عقل. This is not what is referred to. وَالْمُرَادُ بِالْعَقْلِ هُنَا عَقْلُ الرُّشْدِ. يعني that guidance. They were not given that guidance or understanding to know that this was wrong for them to do that. And الرُّشْد is being enlightened to do good deeds. That's what Allah mentions, or Allah's Messenger as he mentions, Khulafa al-Rashideen, al-Mahdiyeen. Rashideen, enlightened to do good deeds. Mahdiyeen refers to knowledge, guided with knowledge. And that is similar to the verse, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهر على الدين كله. He is the one who sent the Messenger with truth. بالهدى. Shaykh Saif Uzan says, with knowledge. Same as Mahdiyin, with knowledge. Wadini al-Haq, same as Rushd, righteous actions. The religion of truth, they are upright upon that, upon righteous actions. So with these two, the deen will become uppermost and will prevail. لِيُظْهِرَ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. So if the people complaining, why is the deen, or why is it in this situation or place, the deen hasn't, the people haven't increased, and people have, why are there issues, why are there problems? Because these two conditions are not met. علم النافع followed by عمل الصالح. Right knowledge, beneficial knowledge followed by righteous actions. And if they were patient until you came out to them, لكان خيرا لهم, then it would be beneficial to them. نعم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا. Or you believe when a sinful person comes to you, then establish the truth regarding his statement, if he says something, he's a fasiq, he's known to be a sinful person, then establish the truth regarding it. Don't ignore him, but establish the truth. Is it true or is it not true, as Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentions in his explanation. جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَعٍ يعني the opposite is if a tiqa of righteous person who is just and trustworthy, if he comes to you with news.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Verse, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu ja'akum fasiqun binabi'in fatabayyanu. The next part is subhanallah. An tusibu qawman bi jahalatin fatusbihu ala ma fa'altum nadimin. That lest that you, if you someone spreads lies and falsehood, lest you oppress a people, then afterwards you become regretful about what you have done. So don't rush, don't be hasty. The fasiqun, they don't check. They put anything out because they don't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so they're clumsy in their accusations. And they don't care for what they're saying. Their thing is, I just want to bring that person down. I'll say whatever I can say against him. Truth, falsehood, anything, just bring it all in one. Just to try to bring that individual down. When he didn't realize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that raises, يُعِزُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ يُذِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. It's Allah that raises, and he's the one who debases. It's not you. And even if you spread your lies, Shaykh Abbad used to mention in his explanation of his book that he wrote, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, Aqwal al-Musafir fi Muawiyah radhiyallahu anhu, he mentioned a nice statement that the Arabs say, La yadurru sahab nabhu al-kilab. The cows would not be harmed by the barking dogs or the barking of dogs. Many of the people can say and lie and cheat and slander and accuse, but the reality is they will not harm the people of Sunnah. لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ مَنْ ضَلَّ إِذَا اهْتَدَيْتُمْ. Allah says, there will no harm will come to you if you are guided. إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ جَمِيعًا فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah will bring all of you to account. And he will tell you all that you used to do. So fear Allah regarding the honor of people. أَنْ تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ. After you become regretful, you start saying sorry. But you have to rectify. Sorry is not enough. Rectify what you have done. Rectify. They rectify what the people have corrupted. The ghuraba. But not only that, the ghuraba themselves, they rectify themselves. They rectify themselves and others. So rectify yourself. That you have accused another individual. And you have lied about another individual. Don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't you know that this piece of flesh, your tongue, will cause you destruction? This tongue, وَهَلْ يَكُبُّ النَّاسِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَ عَلَى مُنَاخِرِهِمْ. إلا حصائد ألسنتهم على وجوههم أو على مناخرهم إلا حصائد ألسنتهم. And how, and the people will be brought and they will be thrown into the hellfire or on their faces into the hellfire on account of what their tongues used to say. This is your tongue. من يضمن لي ما بين لحيي وما بين رجلي أضمن له الجنة. If whoever guards what is between, whoever guarantees that will guard that was between his jaws and that was between his legs, I guarantee him paradise. إن العبد يتكلم بكلمة لا يأخذ لها بال. A person says, a slave or servant says a statement, he doesn't realize where it's going to end up. يهوي بها إلى النار ما بين المشرق والمغرب. He will enter the hellfire, the distance of the east and the west of his statement that he said. The evil statement that he said. It's not a light matter. The angels are writing. And you will be called to account for that statement. And to see قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةً. You lied about them. You slandered them. You spread falsities. And nowadays it doesn't just spread in the community. It spreads worldwide. You call a person such and such. قَدَفْتَ مُسْلِمًا, for example. You said someone has committed zina. And you haven't brought the four witnesses. This is dangerous. You will be whipped. 80 lashes, even if you bring only three witnesses of witnessing the act, you will be whipped 80 lashes. And تصيب قوم بجهالة وتصبح على ما فعلتم نادمين. Or you insult others with names. ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب. بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان. Speaking ill of people with ألقاب, with bad nicknames, evil words, categorizing people, oh this one is this one and that one and that one, in an evil way, in an evil manner. Not wishing guidance for the people. ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب. بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان. That is the sinfulness and transgression after iman. The person insults and he spreads and he mocks. ولا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى يكون خيرا منهم. ولا نساء من نساء عسى يكون خيرا منهم. Men and women both don't spread, don't mock lies and insults against each other in the communities. You cause more harm than good. If you see something that you don't advise, أدين نصيحة, أدين نصيحة, أدين نصيحة. قلنا لمن يا رسول الله؟ قال لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم. Advise. Your right of the Muslim is that you advise him. And if it's an open bid'ah that is brought out, you refute the bid'ah. But with justice. Not with harm, not with transgression, not with lies. Because you want the haq to prevail. And not with mocking the person. Because each and every one of us will be accountable to that. So we ask Allah to forgive us our shortcomings and our deficiencies and that we guard our tongues. And we ask Allah subhanahu to protect us and forgive us, Wallah. Because tomorrow is at Hisab. We will be questioned about this small piece of flesh which Allah has placed two cages, the teeth and the mouth, the lips. In order for you, don't bring it out except that will bring about good. That you do dhikr of Allah, that you recite the Quran, that you enjoin the good and you forbid the evil. Don't let the stahzi' Fulan, you know, you the stahzi' bil ulama. That he's a'mal basar al basir, he's blind in his heart and he's blind in his eyes. Don't use those kind of terminologies. Don't use language about the ulama, about Muslims, the ulama, the Muslims, with bad speech, with evil speech. Speak good or keep silent. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Whoever believes in Allah and the last day, then speak good or keep silent. الصمت السلامة. Silence is salvation. Don't speak ill of somebody. You backbite. ذكرك أخاك بما يكره. That is backbiting. You mention about your brother that which he dislikes. And if it is not true, فقد بهته. Then you have slandered him. Namima, tell carry. The Prophet went past two graves and said, إِنَّهُمَ لَيُعَدَّبَانِ وَمَا يُعَدَّبَانِ فِي كَبِيرًا بَلْ إِنَّهَا كَبِيرًا. They are being punished in the grave. One, he said, it's not a major sin. Then he paused and he said, بَلْ it is a major sin. أَمَّا أَحَدَهُمَا فَكَانَ يَمْشِي بَيْنَ النَّاسِ بِالنَّمِيمَةِ. One of them used to go amongst the people, tail carrying. وَأَمَّا الْآخَرُ فَكَانَ لَا يَسْتَتِرُ مِنْ بَوْلِهِ. He never used to conceal himself from urinating. And Sheikh Abbad mentioned his explanation of Sunan Majah that it means two things. Either it means he didn't conceal himself from the sight of the people whilst urinating, or he didn't conceal his body from the urine whilst urinating. Both of them are prohibited, not allowed for you to do. And in another wording, كَانَ يَمْشِي بَيْنَ النَّاسِ بِالْغِيبَةِ He used to go and backbite between the people. Backbiting is not allowed, except when you are warning the six points that Hafiz al-Nawawi rahimahullah mentions. One of them, One of them is warning, muhadhirin, or the mustaftin, the one who seeks fatwa. Or من طلب الإعانة في إزالة المنكر, or the one who seeks to remove a harm, so he mentions. Or somebody who is mu'arrif, is known for يعني having, for example, ذو اليدين, long arms. That is known nickname or known laqab for him. But if you're not doing any of that, if you're not warning, if you're not going to the qadi, telling him about the situation where you are different with your wife, for example, then, subhanAllah, backbiting is not allowed for you to do in order to enjoy speaking about another person just as a pastime. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was seen to pull out his tongue. This narration is authentic in Sahih Muslim, Muwatta Imam Malik. He was seen to pull out his tongue. Umar al-Khattab said, may Allah forgive you, what is the matter? He said, this has brought me destruction. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, how about us? The Sahaba, they were careful. How about us? The tongue will make you enter the hellfire, Ya Abdullah. If we're not careful about our tongue, may Allah forgive us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rectify our affairs. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us firm upon his deen, upon Tawheed and Sunnah. May Allah guide us to the truth. May Allah guide those who have oppressed us and oppressed the ulama before us. May Allah guide them. Allah yahdihim. May Allah bring them back to the truth. With the slanders, the lies that they have said about the ulama and the people of Sunnah, our brothers in the Maktaba, for example. May Allah guide them. Yani those who have spoken ill about them in an evil way, lies and slanders and oppression. May Allah guide them to the truth. Wallahi, we don't need any jaza' wala shukura, any thanks from the people. And we seek rectification for all. Even those who have oppressed, and even those who have been ardent enemies or ardently against. Why? Because the haq is more beloved to us. So may Allah guide them to the truth and guide us, and that we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إن الله غفور رحيم.